This week in Michigan football history.
Good day. Your beloved maize and blue have thrived on October 9th, historically speaking. On this day in 2016, Michigan produced one of the biggest offensive performances in history, destroying Rutgers 78-0. And all the way back in 1915, we achieved program victory number 200 with a 35-0 shutout of Mount Union. The head coach of that 1915 team was, of course, Michigan's grand old man, Fielding H. Yost. Before Hurry Up landed in Ann Arbor, Yost coached four different teams across the country over a four-year span from 1897 to 1900. He started his career on the sidelines at Ohio Wesleyan, and his battling bishops actually played Michigan in Ann Arbor on this day in 1897. And not only did Yost coach against the school where he would become a legend, but Wesleyan didn't have enough players to fill out the 11-man roster. So Yost, a heralded lineman from his playing days at West Virginia, was permitted to play in the game. And play he did. The game ended in a scoreless tie, a remarkable result for Wesleyan as Yost anchored a strong effort by the Ohio line. As a side note, if the name Ohio Wesleyan rings a bell, it should. It's no mistake that they played the first game ever in Michigan Stadium back in 1927. Then athletic director Yost helped arrange the meeting of his former team to help christen the big house. Yost won wherever he coached, and this was no different. He led the 1897 Wesleyan squad to a 7-1-1 record, including a 6-0 victory over the Buckeyes. Yost being Yost, at the conclusion of the season, he promptly declared Wesleyan to be champions of Ohio. After that 1897 season, Yost headed further west and actually landed exactly where we find our Wolverines today, in Lincoln, Nebraska. Indeed, in 1898, he led the Nebraska Bugeaters, yes, I said Bugeaters, to a conference title. So go blue, beat the Bugeaters, I mean the Cornhuskers. And for more, go to mvictors.com and WTKA.com for the KeyBank countdown to kickoff. This is Greg Dooley.